Hello children, today let us do the revision of chapter number 5. Does it look the same?
Kids, let us revise what we did in chapter 5. Does it look the same? We learned to identify the symmetrical, that is mirror halves images, and non-symmetrical, that is asymmetrical shapes, figures and alphabets. We also learned the clockwise and anti-clockwise half turn and 1/4 turn, and also learned the 1/3 turn and 1/6 turn. Let us revise it again now.
Children, let us first see what is a symmetry. Symmetry means allowing an object to be divided into two equal parts such that one half covers the other similar half completely. In other words, objects are the same on both sides of a line. Usually the line is in the middle. The center line can be located either vertically or horizontally. Let us now see the types of lines of symmetry. Children, basically there are two types of lines of symmetry: vertical and horizontal lines of symmetry. Here you can see a picture of leaf, half an apple and a butterfly, which are good examples of symmetry in nature. English alphabets too have line of symmetry. Children, let us do a symmetry craft. Take a paper, it is a square paper. Fold it into half. Now fold it one more time. Now fold it diagonally, make it a triangle. Now let me just draw a simple curve using a pencil here and carefully cut it with scissors to create a beautiful design. Can you see now? Now this is a symmetrical design. What does that mean? When I draw a symmetrical line horizontally, see, it covers fully. So this is a symmetry line. Suppose I draw a vertical symmetrical line, then also both portions coincides. Now if you see a petal here, you can see a fold here. Let me draw a line of symmetry here and now fold it. See, even the petal, each petal coincides each other. So now you can see a vertical line of symmetry, horizontal line of symmetry, and also the cross lines of symmetry here. These symmetrical designs are very interesting. You will enjoy doing it. And you can also decorate the walls and doors of your room. Try this. Okay? Children, let us now see what are vertical and horizontal lines of symmetry and how do they look in both shapes and English alphabets. First, let us see the vertical line of symmetry. You can see four pictures here where the line of symmetry is drawn vertically in red color. The line of symmetry is always drawn using a dotted line. Why? Because it is an imaginary line. And what is a symmetry? A symmetry means it should divide the picture into two equal halves. That is, when we fold the picture along the dotted line, the left side of the picture should cover the right side of your picture. Now in these pictures, when we draw the line vertically, it forms a line of symmetry. But I have given the line of symmetry horizontally too. Suppose I fold these pictures along the black dotted line, will it give me a mirror image? No. So here the line of symmetry is vertical. Children, let us now see what is a horizontal line of symmetry. Here you can see four pictures where horizontal line of symmetry is drawn in black dotted line. Suppose these pictures are folded along the black dotted line, then this line forms a line of symmetry. That is, the top portion will completely cover the bottom portion. But here the vertical line of symmetry is drawn in red color. If these figures are folded along the red dotted line, will it cover each other completely? No. So we can say here the line of symmetry is horizontal. Children, you just saw shapes and alphabets having only one line of symmetry, either vertical or horizontal. A shape or an alphabet can have more than one line of symmetry. Here are few examples of shapes, designs, and alphabet having two lines of symmetry. In these shapes, if you see, there are two lines of symmetry, one in black color, which is the vertical line of symmetry, and one in red color, which is the horizontal line of symmetry. Suppose you fold these shapes either along the red dotted line or along the black dotted line, the shapes will be symmetrical. Now, let us do an activity to see this practically. Children, I told you there are two basic types of lines of symmetry, vertical and horizontal. I have few English alphabet cuttings. Let us see if these alphabets have any line of symmetry in them, and if they do have, which line of symmetry is it? Let us take the letter E first. Now, I have drawn one vertical line here and one horizontal line here. Let me just fold it along the vertical line. Does it cover? This portion covers this second portion fully? No. So, vertical line of symmetry is not possible in E. Now, let me fold it horizontally. Now, see. Now, this portion coincides with this portion. So, we can say letter E has horizontal line of symmetry. Now, let us take letter M. Again, here I have drawn two lines of symmetry. Let us see now. I'm going to fold it vertically. Does it coincide? Yes, this portion covers this portion fully. So, this is the line of symmetry for M. Now, let me fold it this way. Is it covering? No. So, for M, the line of symmetry is vertical. Now, let us take one more letter X. Here again, I have drawn the two lines of symmetry, vertical, horizontal. I'm going to fold it horizontally. Does it cover each portion fully? Yes. So, it has a horizontal line of symmetry. Now, let me fold it vertically. Again, if you see, two portions cover each other fully. So, even it has a vertical line of symmetry. So, we say letter X has two lines of symmetry, vertical and horizontal. Now, you are clear about the line of symmetry? Children, you just saw few pictures having two lines of symmetry, vertical and horizontal. Now, here are few more pictures having more than two lines of symmetry. The triangle shown here has three lines of symmetry. The square has four lines of symmetry. This six-petaled flower has six lines of symmetry. And finally, the circle has infinite lines of symmetry. Children, let us now see what are asymmetrical shapes or figures. Asymmetry means no symmetry. If a figure is divided into two unequal parts, then such figure is known as asymmetric figure. Let us see an example here. Look at this shape shown here. The dotted line divides the shape into two halves. But if you fold it along the dotted line, the left half will not cover the right half completely. So, the two halves are not mirror halves. So, this is an asymmetric figure. Children, now you know what is a line of symmetry. What is it? It is a line which divides a shape or a figure into two equal halves. You saw certain shapes had only the vertical line of symmetry. Certain had only the horizontal line of symmetry. And you also saw certain shapes had both the vertical and the horizontal lines of symmetry. Certain shapes had more than two lines of symmetry. And now you know a circle has infinite number of lines of symmetry. Now let us see what is an asymmetrical shape. Asymmetry means no symmetry. If a figure is divided into two unequal parts, then such figure is known as asymmetric figure. Let us do an activity here. You can see a cutout of a cloud. This is the vertical line of symmetry. This is the horizontal line of symmetry. Let us see if this cloud has a line of symmetry. I'm going to fold it horizontally now. Is it symmetric? No. It does not coincide with each other. Now let me fold it vertically. Here too, if you see, this does not coincide with each other. Both shapes, you have extra portions here. So this cloud does not have any line of symmetry. Children, did you know there are certain letters in English alphabets which do not have any line of symmetry, like letter S, letter P, etc. Try to find out more English alphabets which do not have any line of symmetry. Okay children, let us see few examples of asymmetrical shapes and alphabet. The pictures shown here are all asymmetrical figures and alphabet. Kids, if you see, both the vertical and the horizontal line of symmetry does not divide the two parts equally. These shapes and alphabet do not have a line of symmetry. They are all asymmetrical shapes and alphabet. Children, at certain times, though the shape might be symmetric, the color scheme of the figure can make it asymmetric. Let us do an activity here. You can see a big circle and four small circles inside it. You all know a circle has infinite number of lines of symmetry. I have drawn two lines of symmetry here. So when I fold it along the horizontal line of symmetry, this color should match with this color. But here it is blue, here it is green. In the same manner, if I fold it along the vertical line of symmetry, again this color should match with this. And here it is green, here it is blue. So the color scheme does not match in this shape. So we can say, though this shape is symmetric, because of the color scheme, this shape is a symmetric shape. Followed? Children, let us see if these shapes are divided into two mirror halves by the dotted lines. You can see three figures having the line of symmetry drawn. Children, just by seeing the shapes, we can make out that if we fold these shapes along the given dotted line, it will be symmetric. But as you just saw the video where I told you, the color scheme should also be same. So here, when we fold these shapes along the given dotted line, the color scheme will not be same. So children, these shapes are asymmetric. Mirror image. Children, when we see ourselves in a mirror, what do we see? We see our image, which is exactly the same except reversed. The right side of us appears on the left side and vice versa. Children, here are few pictures and their mirror images. If you see the second picture, the math magic book is there and you can read the word math magic. But if you see the reflection, you cannot read it. It is reverse. And same way, the pens kept along with the book, the lids are facing you in this picture, and in the mirror image, it is facing the other side. That is, it is reversed. This is same in both the other pictures also. So we can say, though the mirror images are exactly same, except they are reversed. Half a term. Children, let us see what is half a term. You can see two figures here, figure 1 and figure 2. The front of the car is facing downwards in figure 1, and in figure 2 it is in the opposite direction to the direction it started in. That is, the front of the car is facing upwards. It has made half a turn clockwise. The black arrow shows the clockwise direction, and it has made half turn anti-clockwise. The red arrow shows the anti-clockwise direction. Children, the final position, if you see, of the car is the same in both half turns. However, the direction taken to get there is different. Children, certain shapes like square, rectangle, circle, elongated rectangle, hexagon would look the same after half a turn. In the same manner, English alphabets H, N, I looks the same after half turn. And also numbers like 8,888 looks same after the half turn. The final position of the shape will be the same in both half turns. However, the direction taken to get there is different. Children, let us now see the 1/4 turn both clockwise and anti-clockwise direction. The first set shows the clockwise direction shown by green arrow mark. It goes to your right, then down, then to your left. And the second set shows the anti-clockwise direction. It is shown by the brown color arrow mark. It goes to left, then down, then to your right. Children, here you can see the quarter turn in both the pictures. The first one is clockwise direction and the second one is anti-clockwise direction. In the first one, if you see, the arrow marks are moving on your right side. The red dot, if you see, it is on the top, then to your right, then down, then to your left. And in the second picture, if you see the green color, which is on the top, in the second, it is in your left. Then in the third, it is bottom. And in the fourth, it is on your right. So this is anti-clockwise direction. Followed, these two are clear examples of clockwise and anti-clockwise 1/4 turn or quarter turn. Okay. Children, let us now see what is half a turn and a quarter turn. Now you are familiar with this. This is a degree clock. I have drawn one vertical line which divides the circle into two equal parts and one horizontal line. That means these are four equal parts. Now I am going to keep a pencil like this. The lid is facing the top. Now half turn means it will come like this till here. This is half. So now when it comes like this, it has taken half a turn. It is facing downwards and this is clockwise direction. Now let us see how does the anti-clockwise direction work. Now I have kept the pencil here. Anti-clockwise direction means in my left. So it will come like this. It has taken half a turn. So it is facing down. So half a turn, both clockwise and anti-clockwise will be same. The position will be same. Only the direction taken will be different. The clockwise will be from the right side and the anti-clockwise will be from the left side. Now let us see quarter turn, clockwise. Pencil is like this. This is quarter. So the first quarter is, quarter turn will be like this. This is clockwise, half turn. You know now half turn. Then 3/4 turn, full turn. That is the fourth quarter turn. This is clockwise direction. Now anti-clockwise from your left. First turn, half turn will be same, only the direction changes. Now my 3/4 turn and fourth quarter turn. So clockwise means this direction, anti-clockwise means this direction. Did you follow? 1/3 and 1/6 turn. Any shape having three tips will make an 1/3 turn when it moves from one tip to the other. Here, this shape will look the same on 1/3 turn and also on 1/6 turn. Now in the second picture, it has 6 tips. So when it moves from one tip to the other, it makes an turn of 1/6. So the shape shown will look same on 1/6 turn. Followed?
Children, we have come to the end of this revision session. Revise thoroughly. Take care and bye.